I try and do it discreetly so my mom doesn't find out. So, but best believe I like to go fast on motorcycles. I really hope that my mom doesn't see any of this, because then she's going to know that I've been doing it behind her back. I've been riding motorcycles ever since I was in my early teens, and yeah, I was forbidden from doing so at one point by my mom, who's very concerned about my health and safety because I like to go fast, and she doesn't trust me enough to ride safely. So nowadays I do it under a helmet, very, very discreetly, but it's something that gives me a sense of liberty, freedom, adrenaline, a rush, and yeah, I love motorsport, and that's why Carrera is a perfect fit.
Awesome. And down to the last question, one thing you want to tell about your upcoming movie?
One thing that I want to tell you about my upcoming movies, well, I'm starting Simba very soon. I just completed Gully Boy, and I have 1983 to follow. Gully Boy is a very, very special story, one that I'm very closely attached to. It's about, it's set against the backdrop of this flourishing Desi hip-hop scene coming out of Bombay. It is a story that is very, very Mumbai city. So that being my hometown, born and raised, you know, these are my people, this is my language, this is a story that I'm really, really attached to. It's an underdog story about a kid who broke through from great adversity in life to make it as a recording artist. Simba, of course, my first collaboration with Rohit Shetty, which I know people are very excited about, me more than anyone, you know, to be diving into the masala genre with the king of the genre is an incredible opportunity that I'm extremely excited to be commencing principal shooting in about a month's time. I'm starting prep for the film tomorrow, hopefully wearing aviator Carreras throughout the film. So yeah, tomorrow I start the physical work. Mr. Rohit Shetty is very keen that I have big muscles in the film. Jab tu wardi pehnega na, to wardi fatni chahiye. So he wants me to wear a pair of, you know, aviators, and we are actually already in talks with Carrera for the same. Of course, 1983, which is you know, the story of the 1983 World Cup, a significant event in our history, full of national pride, and a very interesting story. You know, when Mr. Kabir Khan first came to me with the film, he said, "We're making the film on 1983." I said, "Finally, somebody is making that film." But when he told me the story, I realized what an insane underdog story it is. A bunch of ragtag underdogs that nobody believed in, that went on to, you know, fight against the odds, be brave, and had the ultimate triumph. You know, so a story that's extremely significant in our history as a nation, and most definitely one that shaped sports and cricket into what it is today, something that I'm very proud to be a part of. So I'm very excited about my upcoming slate, and I really hope that you enjoy all of those films.
Thank you. Once again, can we have a big round of applause? That does bring us to the end of the show. Thank you, Mr. Kofinas. Thank you, Ms. Gupta. And of course, Ranveer Singh, thank you so much for taking our time.
I wanted to ask him a question.
Yes. Of course, please, ma'am, if you'd like to ask, please go ahead. No, that's why in the beginning I had said, but please go ahead, all yours.
Okay, my question to you is, in this film, you, I call it a film, you were very candid, I mean, extremely. Have you ever been so open and transparent and candid before? If not, then how come now?
I think it has to do a lot with this man over here who just kept egging me on, and he kept... The thing is, these stories are something that come from a very deep ember in your heart. And if the person who's listening is a good listener, he was behind the camera, really invested in my story, really listening to what I had to say. And as the story kept unraveling, I kept going deeper and deeper and pulling out more memories and insights. And before you know it, I got caught up in the emotion myself. And it's only when the ready film came to me to see did I realize, one, that it's a great film, but two, that my own story is pretty unique. You know, my journey is quite something. It's straight out of a movie script. I just finished collaborating with Zoya Akhtar. She made a film called Luck by Chance. You know, that was her first film. It's like the story of my life. Guy out of nowhere, you know, hustling hard, trying to make it, trying to break through as a movie star. And